Good morning, children. Welcome to the online session of Sri Gokulam Public School, Guruvayur. Children, we were dealing with the chapter Marketing Management and we were discussing about the marketing mix. We saw that there are four important P's related to marketing mix. They were product, price, physical distribution and promotion. We already discussed the product. Now, let us discuss about pricing. Pricing involves determination of price of a product. So, what do you mean by pricing? It involves determination of fixing a price for a product. Price may be defined as the amount of money paid by a buyer in consideration of the purchase of a product or services. So, if a buyer is purchasing a product or services, so he have to pay something in return of that product or services. That part of money which he is paying, it is known as price. Level of price affect the demand for a product. Generally, lower the price, higher would be the demand for the product and vice versa. So, we can say that if demand is more, the price of that product will be higher. And if demand is less, then the price of that product will be less. Price is an important factor affecting the success or failure of a product in the market, as it affects the revenue and profit of the firm. So, the revenue and profit of the firm is attached with the price of the product, which also affects the success and failure of the product in the market. Now let us see the factors affecting the price determination. There are six factors which you have to remember. The first factor is product cost. Second one, the utility and demand. Third one, extent of competition in the market. Fourth point is fixing pricing objectives. Fifth point is government and legal regulations. And sixth point is marketing method use. So, all these six factors affect the price determination. Now, let us see each of these factors. The first factor was product cost. Product cost include the cost of procuring, distribution and selling the product. So, what is product cost? For producing this product, what cost you have incurred, that is your product cost. So, it may include the cost of procuring the raw material and other product for producing that item, and also the distribution and selling expenses is your total cost. Generally, all marketing firms strive to cover their total cost at least in the long run. So, it is very important for every firm to cover their cost at least for in a long run. In addition, they aim at earning a margin of profit over and above the cost. So, they also want a profit which is above their cost. Then only the firm will have a growth prospect. So, if a firm is thinking about the growth prospect, then they should fix a cost, or you can say that their earning margin of profit should be over and above the cost. In the long run, no organization will survive if it is charged a lower price than its product cost. So, every organization, they have to fix a cost. They should cover the cost so that they can survive in the market. Okay? For their survival, they should cover the cost of their product. The next factor is the utility and demand. Price of a product depends to a large extent on its utility and demand. So, what benefit the product is giving to the customer and its demand, these two is very much important while fixing the price of a product. A buyer buys a product only when he feels that the utility of the product is at least equal to its price. So, when you go to a market to buy a product, you will check that product price and you will check the benefit which the product will give to you. So, if the product is giving you utility which is equal to its price, then only you will buy a product. Similarly, product demand also affects its price. If demand is high, higher price is likely to be charged. In the case of low demand, price tend to be lower. So, if demand is high, higher price. And if demand is low, lower price. The next factor which affects the pricing decision is extent of competition. Competitors' price and their anticipated reaction must be considered before fixing the price of a product. So, if you are fixing a price of a product, you have to check out the price of your competitors and their reaction on that prices. Not only the price, but the quality and the features of the competitive product must be examined carefully before fixing the price. In perfect competition, no competitor is in a position to charge higher price as compared to its competitor. In imperfect competition, chances of charging higher price exist. So, if there is perfect competition, we cannot go for a fixation of higher charge. But in case of imperfect competition, then we can charge a higher price for our product. Next, fourth factor is pricing objective. So, every company, they have their own pricing objective. Let us see which are the pricing, different types of pricing objectives. First one is profit maximization. If the firm decides to maximize profit in short run, it will charge maximum price for its product. This point says that if the firm want to maximize their profit within a short period of time, within a short span, they have to maximize their profit, then they will fix a maximum price for their product. But if they want to maximize their profit in long run, then they will charge lower price for their product, and by doing this they can capture large market share and they can earn greater profit through increased sales because their cost is less, so more customers will be attracted and they will have a larger market share and thereby increase their profit through increasing their sales. The next pricing objective available is obtaining market share leadership. If a firm's objective is to obtain larger share of market, it will keep the price of its product at a lower level so that greater number of people are attracted to purchase the product. So, one way of attracting the maximum customers to your product is charging lower price. And by charging lower price, one can obtain larger share of market. So, that is one pricing objective available, that is obtaining market share leadership. The next point is surviving in a competitive market. If a firm is facing difficulty in surviving in the market because of intensive competition, it will charge the lowest possible price and offer discount also. So, it is very, the market is too competitive. Your product are having many competitors. So, to survive in the market, the only option available is to charge the lowest possible price, and not only that, you have to offer discount also so that you can survive in the market. The next pricing objective available is attaining product quality leadership. In this case, the firm charges higher price for providing high quality products because it incurs heavy expenditure on research and development. So, a firm which is giving a quality product, they they have to frequently go for a research and development, which is an expenditure. High expenditure is incurred on the research and development conducted by a company, which frequently go for adding new quality and features to their product. So that research and development expenditure will be added to the price of the product, and automatically the price of the product will increase. So that is one objective, pricing objective. By increasing the quality, one can attract the customer, and they have to charge higher price so that they can incur heavy expenditure on research and development for their product. The fifth objective is government and legal regulations. So government has the power to regulate price fixation mechanism for essential product. You know that what are the list of essential product. So those essential products price will be fixed by the government. In certain cases, prices are directly fixed by the government, known as administered price mechanism. For examples of administered price mechanism are petroleum products like petrol, diesel, kerosene and cooking oil. In some cases, the formula for price fixation is determined by the government. For example, medicines. So for medicines and all, the government give the formula how the company should fix a price for that product. So this is one pricing objectives. Pricing factors. Then we have marketing method use. So price fixation is also affected by the marketing method use, such as the distribution system, quality of salesman employed, degree of advertising, sales promotion efforts, additional benefits like free home delivery. So if the company is offering this all facilities, the price will increase. So on the prices of the product depends also on the marketing method used by the company.
Now children, it is time to conclude today's class. In today's class, we have discussed one of the marketing mix, that is pricing. We saw the factors which determine the price and how a company fixes a price for its product after determining these all factors. So in total, there are six factors which you have to study. This is a very important question from the exam's point of view. So go through the notes provided and underline the main points from your textbook while you read the chapter containing this topic. A test paper is also attached, so do attend the test paper. Meet you in the next class with the new marketing mix, that is physical distribution. Till then, goodbye, take care.